In the opening scene, we see several secret CIA agents getting murdered in Moscow by the Russian government under the direction of KGB director. Yasilyav nailed that their heads are brutally chopped and sent to the U.S. mission as a chilling message. The scene then cuts to 5 years later, and we see a man named Sammy, who is on the lookout for possible models for a Paris-based firm. His journey leads him to a local Moscow market, where he notices a beautiful young woman named Anna selling Matryoshka dolls. Sammy extends an offer to Anna, suggesting that she consider a job in modeling with all living costs covered by the organization. The latter thinks for a while, and finally accepts. The very next day, Anna arrives in Paris, and is introduced to the modeling firm there. She meets an operator named Dorothy in the agency's head. John Dorothy then shows her the flat, which she'll be sharing with other girls. Anna is surprisingly paired with the photo shooting session the following day without any experience or training. As a result of this, she originally struggles with posing and facial gestures. Must be tough. But being a fast learner, she quickly adapts to her new job, delivering impressive poses and expressions. After a long day, Anna returns to a room only to find some fellow models engaged in intimate activities in her bed. She tackles them, but the group makes fun of her and asks her to join in as well. Come, Anna, we all share our butts. Annoyed, Anna leaves and chooses to share a room with another model, Maud. One evening, the agency throws a dinner party for all its partners, including the models. During this, John introduces Anna to Oleg Filenkov, one of the partners of the firm. Oleg seems to be charmed by Anna's beauty and openly flirts with her. After a brief chat, he asks her out for dinner, and she agrees. 2 months pass by, and we see the pair kissing at a luxurious hotel suite. When Oleg seeks further intimacy, Anna hesitates, believing it to be too soon. 2 months. She asks more about him as well as about his job in response. He admits that he supplies weapons to war-torn countries for a living. After getting that information, she needs. Anna goes to the bathroom and takes out a secret mic from her outfit. She then takes a moment to calm herself, and then gets a handgun to shoot him dead back to 3 years earlier. We see Anna, who lives with her violent boyfriend named Piotr. It turns out that she's been suffering years of her boyfriend's domestic abuse. She is forced to join in stealing money from the credit cards of kidnapped foreigners, and if she refuses, she gets beaten up. As a result of these tortures, she is ready to do anything to leave the life she is stuck in. In pursuit of freedom, Anna sends multiple applications to join the Russian Navy through different forms, yet gets no response. One night, Piotr and his accomplices kidnap an American person, subjecting him to a violent attack while demanding the ATM card's PIN. As usual, Anna is helpless to intervene and can only stay inside the car. This time, they are spotted by the police, causing them to drive away. The chase begins, and Piotr roughly drives through the streets of Moscow in a desperate bid to escape the cops. Before long, their car collides with another car, causing it to crash and flip upside down. Thankfully, Piotr and Anna manage to live with minor injuries. The pair then quickly makes their way home on foot. Upon their return, Anna sees a KGB agent named Alex waiting behind the door. He attaches a silencer to his pistol and shoots Piotr to death. Despite the grim sight, Anna stays calm and unaffected, which leaves an effect on the officer. Alex seems to know everything about Anna and offers her a fresh start to work for the KGB. He outlines a plan involving 1 year of study and 4 years of field work, offering her eventual freedom, believing that it might be another trap. Anna rejects the offer and cuts herself as the blood drips down. Alex urges her to put faith in herself rather than rely on others. This finally convinces Anna, so she covers her wound and accepts his idea. After a year of training, Alex introduces Anna to the senior KGB handler, Olga. The latter is reluctant to hire Anna under her department, if she thinks Anna is just a pretty face who can be used as a honey trap. However, Anna swiftly impresses Olga with her keen intellect and excellent skills in chess. As a result, Olga tasks Anna with a plan to eliminate a Russian drug lord at a cafe within a tight time limit of 5 minutes. Anna is completely unaware of the presence of armed security and the situation inside the cafe. Nevertheless, she enters the cafe and draws her weapon on the drug lord, only to find that it's unloaded. As a consequence, the armed bodyguards arrive to attack her. This forces her to engage in close battle. Surprisingly, Anna turns out to be a skilled fighter, and she takes down the guards one after another. As she wipes out all of them, the drug lord smacks her head from behind. He tries to strangle her, but she somehow manages to reach a fork and repeatedly stabs him until he succumbs to his injuries. But despite all of this, Anna exceeds the time limit by 1 minute, leading Olga to deem her goal a failure. Later, Anna confronts Olga in her office, charging her of setting up a trap to get her killed in return. Olga suggests that one should always be extra careful, because danger never sends warnings. She then drives Anna to her new apartment, and before leaving hands her a stack of files regarding her next target, telling her to study them in detail the following day. Anna is going through the target's files when she gets a call from Alex. He appears to have love for her, so he asks her out for dinner. Anna says that she would love to see him, but she is already too busy at the moment. As a result, the two agree to meet some other time. The mission day finally comes, and it turns out that she has to kill Oleg, and it does it. Quickly, as shown in the previous scene here, it is stated that the entire Paris model scouting action was part of the KGB's plan to kill Oleg. Anna intentionally positioned herself at the neighborhood market, where she caught the eye of Sammy. A part of the plan, she flew to Paris, where she established a new job as a top model. In order to escape suspicion, Olga endorsed her to start a bond with Maude. After killing Oleg, Anna used a body double to wipe the hotel's security tapes. Now that some spy style at presence, Anna is being probed by a CIA agent named Lenny Miller regarding Oleg's murder. In response, she claims that she did indeed go to the hotel as shown by street camera footage. Anna says that she waited for Oleg in the lounge, but he didn't show up, lacking concrete proof against her that agents let her go. In the next scene, Anna returns to Moscow after successfully finishing her mission. While in her room, she is visited by Alex. They look to be seeing each other after a long time, so they immediately start making out, switching tongues for the motherland. The following day, Olga, Alex, and Anna go to meet Vasilev. Sadly, he refuses to honor the original deal and dismisses the notion of giving Anna freedom in 5 years when she presses the issue he culture at gunpoint, claiming that former spies pose a liability to the agency and that the only road to freedom is death. Even Olga and Alex are unable to say a word in front of Vasilev, disheartened, and returns to Paris and continues her job as a model. On a particular day, she calls Alex, expressing her dissatisfaction at being unable to live freely. Alex tells her not to lose hope, as there might be some way out. Anna asks if he will back her if she ever plans to run away, to which he answers that he'll try his best. Soft answer. A few days later, Anna is called by Olga for the next mission. The goal is a man named Wurttemberg, who is looking for an escort to please him in a hotel room. Olga informs her that the room includes no comms or listening devices. Because of this, she won't be able to watch her, and she is on her own in this mission. After a while, Anna disguises herself as a guard and enters the target's room. She asks Wurttemberg to wait for a minute. Faking to use the bathroom inside, she gets a gun, catches a silencer, and walks out to shoot him dead. Following this, she retrieves Wurttemberg's bag and returns to Olga in the other room of the same hotel. Olga doesn't appear to be pleased by her work because she took 12 minutes, which is longer than she usually takes. Moreover, Anna didn't bring the index finger of the target as stated in the job detail. Due to this, Anna comes back to the target's room, mutilates an index finger, and brings it back. At this point of time, Anna breaks down in tears and asks how many more she has to kill. Sensing her frustration, Olga tells her to take a week-long trip with Maude, and his vacation shows to be really useful, as she needed it for a long time. She then returns back to work in a completely refreshed state. I am ready to kill again. From that day onwards, Anna carries out numerous jobs efficiently, which strikes Olga simultaneously. She also excels in her modeling job. Several months pass, and Vasilev, who is pleased with her performance, summons her to Moscow for a meeting. As soon as Anna lands in Moscow, she proceeds to the KGB office and meets Alex. Overwhelmed by their feelings, they quickly sneak into a storage room and get it on. After satisfied themselves, Anna enters Vasilya's house, where they have a chat over a chess game. While sitting nearby, Alex notices Anna's suspicious hand movements under the table. In a surprising turn of events, Anna Vasilev in the game, and at the same time she grabs her gun and shoots him right in his fat head. The scene then goes back to 6 months earlier, when Anna was tasked with eliminating Wurttemberg on that day. As she walked out from the bathroom, she was shocked to find Agent Lenny and his team waiting to capture her red-handed. Once cuffing her hands, Lenny offered her to work for them as a double spy in exchange for 1 year of her service. He promised her freedom and a safe life in Hawaii, left with limited choice, and accepted the offer before splitting ways. Though she asked him about how Lenny managed to catch her, to which he replied that he recognized the way she held her bag. Lenny's got away with bags. This entire scenario is the reason why it took 12 minutes to return to Olga. That day, during her 1 week break, Lenny came to check up on her, and they had a brief talk. Inside a closet, he asked her for dinner, but she couldn't do so because Olga was still spying on her. However, they quietly met in his room that night, and the two made out. Lenny's up to more bag tricks since Then they started to meet more often, even after returning to Paris one day. Lenny assigned her with a job to complete Vasilia because he was frightening the friendly relationship between KGB and the CIA. He also shared with Anna about how he was the head of CIA in Moscow when Vasiliev killed 9 U.S. intelligence agents in a single day. In order to persuade Anna, he offered early freedom upon successful finishing of the goal. And she agreed back to the present day after assassinating Vasilia. Anna immediately holds Alex at gunpoint and injects him with a drug, making him shape. Following this, she extracts important data from Vasilia's computer onto a flash drive and leaves Alex. Despite his tired state, manages to crawl toward Vasilia's table and triggers an emergency button beneath it, alerting the security team. However, Anna, being a highly skilled fighter, incapacitates all the guards on her way out. Despite this, she fails to reach the rendezvous point in time where Lenny is waiting for her. This terrible delay leads Lenny to think that Anna has betrayed him, prompting his lead. After this, he goes to Maud's place and tells her to notify him as soon as Anna contacts her. Lenny then flies back to New York, where he's recognized for successfully eliminating Vasilia one day. While in his office, Lenny gets a message from Anna, asking him to meet at a specific coffee shop in a park. Lenny heads to the spot only to discover Alex instead. Both men know each other and inform their respective teams, who are secretly backing them up. Shortly after, Anna comes on the scene and shares kisses with both guys. Now that's a double spy. It turns out that she deliberately planned the meeting with the two rivals. She returns their vital information she had previously stolen to each of them. However, she claims to have kept a copy, which she will reveal if either party betrays her by accepting the return of their data. Lenny and Alex allow Anna to walk away towards her freedom, unseen to all of them. The meeting area is under the tracking of Olga. Shortly after Anna leaves the meeting, Olga gets up to her and fatally shoots her for failing the KGB. Lenny and Alex find themselves holding each other at gunpoint, but are finally forced to retreat. 3 months earlier, Anna and Olga met for an information update. During this meeting, Olga stated that she was aware that the CIA got Anna because she had noticed cuff marks on hands during the Württemberg mission, and she knew that Württemberg liked whips and feathers. Despite this, Olga told her to do what they say, allowing her to kill Vasilia. Olga had a personal reason for this choice. She wanted to take Vasilia's position, and Slater explained that Olga's shooting of Anna at the park was made as Anna had been wearing a bulletproof vest. They quickly use a body double to fake her death, while the real Anna slipped into the tunnels, changed her clothes, and took the wig from her shaved head before vanishing into the crowds. Finally free in the wake of these events, Olga is chosen as Vasilia of replacement, just as she wanted. As she opens her computer, she discovers Anna's database connected with a video message. In the movie, Anna expresses her thanks to Olga, but also reveals that she has recorded their last chat station, in which Olga had admitted to backing the CIA's plan to kill Vasily if she did it in case Olga betrays their deal. Olga smirks and then honors in his final request, which is deleting her name from the KGB database. Subscribe for more movies like this, turn on notifications, and leave a like to help the channel out.